I'm Shelly Short. I'm your state senator from the 7th Legislative District. Welcome to this legislative update. Well, there have been some interesting developments on that. You know, we've been watching what the Senate Chair of Law and Justice, Moncadingra, you know, she's refused to, you know, to advance any bill that would actually fix police pursuits. So the only bill that came out of her committee was one to study it. You know, that's kind of Olympia code for do nothing, and it kicks the can down the road. So it does nothing to fix what we and law enforcement and you and your communities are seeing in your neighborhoods and in your towns and cities, that crime is just rampant. Vehicle thefts are just off the charts. The State Patrol says car thefts are up 50%. Used to be 30,000 a year, now it's 45,000 a year. The number of incidents that would have justified pursuit have tripled. Used to be about 1,200 a year, now it's 3,100 a year. Even their own members, Democratic leaders, are saying this is nuts. They're getting tremendous pressure to act with real solutions, but there are still so many of them that believe that, you know, that cops are the problem. Cops are not the problem here. We need to give law enforcement those tools back so they can continue to keep our community safe. Now you go over to the House of Representatives, and their committee work was pretty interesting. They actually passed a bill that restored some police pursuits. It still didn't address the biggest issue, which is vehicle thefts. Well, folks are going to say, look, this is sometimes what compromise looks like. You know, you start going one direction and you end up putting something out there. And right, it's better than nothing. It's something to work with. But I've got to tell you, we have a duty as a legislature to fix this. And we have community leaders, we have citizens, we have our local law enforcement that they're saying, we need to restore police pursuit. This is allowing rampant crime, allowing criminals to just take off, not stop for law enforcement. We would argue it's actually making people more vulnerable, not less. And we're gonna see a lot of things this session. This issue is not done. I know that we are going to have other opportunities to maybe amend the bill in different committees, maybe on the floor, but I want folks to know back home that this is our number one issue. This has been your number one issue that you have shared with us and your concerns for public safety and getting law enforcement the tools, restore those tools that they so desperately need. So we are going to continue to work every angle possible. We're not giving up on this. It's just very interesting when you see the differences between the House and Senate and how they're handling it. So stay tuned.